Now see, this is the exercise 6.2 and here is the question number 1. We have to find the value of the x and y, and then we have to prove that AB is parallel to CD. Now here one thing that we don't know, that these two are the parallel, so we are not using over here data corresponding angles and alternate interior angles and alternate exterior angles, all these. So just we have to see that if we watch this point, okay, this point here, the two line intersect each other, means here we can apply the condition of the vertically opposite angles and see this make a straight line. That's why we are using here linear angles property. Okay, so as 50 plus x, because these two make a straight line, means these are the linear angles, is equal to 180 degree. It means x equals to 180 minus 50, means 130 degree. So the value of the x is 130 degree. Okay, the value of the x is 130 degree. Now we have to find the value of the y, so that is okay. Now see this part here, the two lines intersect each other, means the y is vertically opposite to 130, and as we know that vertically opposite angles are equal to each other, it means y is equal to 130 degree, and you can write in bracket vertically opposite angles. Now you have seen that x is also 130 degree and y is also 130 degree, it means x is equal to y. And if x is equal to y, means this is equal to this y, that this x is equal to y, means this one, just wait. Now here we find that x is equal to y, means this angle, okay, this is equal to this one. So these two are the alternate interior angles. Okay, these two are the alternate interior angles, and this condition only satisfy when there are the two parallel line and one line transverse, or one line intersect these two lines. So here it means AB is parallel to CD, because this is only possible when the two lines are parallel.